In the state's southeastern corner, power is coming back on, but not quickly enough for businesses.
News 8's Tina Detel takes us to the Pawcatuck section of Stonington, where some businesses are trying to clean up.
It's a cleanup of a different kind after the storm here at Seafood Etc. Now, the first to go were the lobsters from this now spotless tank. The walk-in coolers, freezers, refrigerators, and display cases are all clean and empty, a process which began while the storm struck Sunday.
We emptied 5 or 6 crates of lobsters out of the tanks, lost about half of them probably, but...
Sharon Clatchery tried to transfer the rest of the seafood to other locations, but had to throw out quite a bit of it.
A lot of dumpster fills.
How much product did you lose?
It's in the thousands. I haven't done a full inventory yet, but it's not pretty.
Clatchery isn't sure how long she will be shut down and how long it will be before the lights are on and she can put specials back on this board.
Loss of business is just as bad, you know. We've been closed since Saturday night.
No income, not a good thing. You can deal with it at home, but when it's your business, it's definitely very scary.
Jen Bogue calls it deja vu. Last year it was a flood, and this year a hurricane shut down her sandwich shop. But just until Wednesday, while we were in Pawcatuck, her power came back on.
I'm happy now.
Seafood Etc. is hoping for the same celebration before the normally busy Labor Day weekend arrives.
We're playing minute by minute, you know. When the power comes on, it's a whole new story. Till then, we're just in limbo here.
A bit of relief for at least one part of Pawcatuck. Now, these same businesses were actually closed for 2.5 weeks during last year's floods. On the scene in the Pawcatuck section of Stonington, Tina Detel, News 8.